Slave rebellions occurred on the island of Puerto Rico as early as 1527, with Maroons escaping into the mountains and establishing societies with the surviving Taínos. By 1873, enslaved Africans had orchestrated more than 20 revolts on the island. The most popular was that of Marcos Xiorro, who led a rebellion in 1821. Following the success of the Haitian Revolution in 1804, many of the French that fled moved to Puerto Rico, where they settled and made the island one of the largest exporters of sugar. Not long after, slave owners on the island started having suspicions that the Haitians were planning to attack all the Spanish colonies. Because of this, any offenses by slaves in Puerto Rico, even the most trivial, were met with severe brutality. It was this context and atmosphere that propelled Marcos Xiorro to take action. Xiorro was a slave on a sugar plantation in Bayamon, Puerto Rico, owned by a militia captain, Vicente Andino. Very little is known about Xiorro's early years, with some historians saying he was born into slavery and others suggesting he came directly from Africa. Described as literate and charismatic, Marcos Xiorro, along with other slaves, hatched a plan for a rebellion that was to begin on July 27th of 1821, a date which coincided with religious festival celebrations on the island. According to his plan, several slaves were to escape from various plantations in Bayamón. They were to proceed to the sugarcane fields of Miguel Figueres and retrieve cutlasses and swords which had been hidden in those fields. Marcos Xiorro, together with Mario, a slave from another local plantation, and another slave named Narciso, would lead the slaves from Toya Baja, and together with the slaves from Bayamón, would capture the city of Bayamón. They would burn the city and kill all those who they deemed their oppressors. After this, they planned to unite with slaves from the adjoining towns of Rio Piedras, Guanabo, and Palo Seco. With this critical mass of slaves, all armed and emboldened from a series of quick victories, they would invade the capital city of San Juan, where they would declare Marcos Xiorro their king. Had it not been for a slave named Ambrosio, no one knows how successful this plan might have been. Ambrosio was the loyal slave of Miguel Figueres, the owner of the sugar fields where the rebel slaves had hidden weapons. Ambrosio told Figueres of Xiorro's plan. At the time, slaves who alerted their owners of planned revolts were rewarded with freedom and a sum of 500 pesos. Ambrosio's owner, Figueres, informed the mayor of Bayamón about the planned revolt, who then dispatched 500 soldiers. They pursued the slaves quickly, capturing the ringleaders and followers of the conspiracy. A total of 61 slaves were imprisoned in Bayamón and San Juan. By August 15, 1821, the court trials against the conspirators was completed. A total of 17 slaves were punished, and Mario and Narciso, considered to be ringleaders, were both executed. Xiorro was captured on August 14th in the city of Mayagüez. He was tried separately, and his fate is unknown, but most think he was most likely executed. Marcos Xiorro and those with him dared to be free men and a system that condemned them as slaves. For this, they paid with their lives. Their only actual crime was wanting to be free. And even though the revolt was not successful, Marcos Xiorro became a legend among the island's slave population and is now part of Puerto Rican folklore. The Spanish National Assembly finally abolished slavery in Puerto Rico on March 22, 1873. However, the slave owners were compensated with 35 million pesetas per slave, and slaves were still required to continue working for 3 more years. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Help us to spread this video by sharing. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell for more videos.